Hello and welcome back to Microsoft Mechanics Live. Coming up, we're going to have a treat here. We're going to be joined by Jack Elmore. He's going to take on the challenge of demoing the latest modern desktop experiences with Office 365 Pro Plus and Windows 10 client updates in 10 minutes or less as part of our annual Demopalooza Challenge. Now, in the time that we have, we're going to try to look at as many of the latest or lesser known capabilities and innovations that we can across AI, teamwork, creativity, and security. Anybody think Jack can do it? All right, we're going to try to beat 12 from last year. But please give me a warm welcome for Jack Elmore from the Microsoft 365 team.
Thanks, Jeremy. Good afternoon, Ignite.
Thank you, Jack. So there's been a lot of focus on modern desktop with Microsoft 365 and Windows 10 and Office 365 Pro Plus and all the integrated security across EMS, all the management capabilities that we have there. I thought we'd invite you back on the show to really make this real for all of us. Because last time you were on with us, you actually wowed us with AI and real-time translation and a bunch of other things. You got in about 12 demos in 10 minutes. And despite me giving you a bunch of grief the whole time, I promise I'm going to be better this time. I'm not going to try to take
you off course. I appreciate it. My feelings were really hurt last time. It took me a long time to get over it.
I'm going to be more supportive, I promise. So we've got 10 minutes again. Let's get the timer queued up and ready.
Okay, let's do this.
All right, looks like we got 10 minutes on the clock. Are you ready to go?
I'm ready.
All right, and go.
All right, first, AI isn't a product. It's integrated into everything we do in Microsoft 365 and Azure. You can see Cortana is my personal assistant. She interprets my mail and keeps track of commitments I make, like the PowerPoint I promised you by 1 o'clock.
Yeah, I was wondering about that. I bet Cortana can't actually give me a PowerPoint presentation, can she?
Well, hold on a moment, because AI in PowerPoint and across the suite can deliver some amazing results. We announced this morning the new Ideas capability. Now, last year, I showed you PowerPoint Designer and a variety of intelligence tools. I had to know where those tools are and invoke them myself. Ideas brings all of these intelligence features to me. St. Louis is our newest MTC that opened last week. I look after the Seattle, and you'll notice when I type the word Seattle on the right-hand side, Ideas is suggesting I may want to include a photo to make this look a little bit better, so let's do that. Now Ideas iterates, comes back, says you got a photo, but it doesn't look very good. How about we give you a layout to make the photo look amazing?
Much, all right. Much better.
Now, very cool. Let's move on to slide number two, and let's see what Ideas can do to help me here. Ideas now is sorting out that I'm not very consistent with respect to how I use punctuation. So it's saying semicolons, commas, periods, and none. How about we just tighten that up a little bit, make it a little bit more consistent? And then when I go to slide three, we're going to get a different set of coaching here. Now, I don't want to debate with you whether website has a space in the middle of it or not. Let's just pick one and tighten it all up, right? So there you go. In just a few clicks, that's intelligence coming to me in a way that's not obtrusive, comes alongside to help without getting in the way. What do you think? Is it going to help you?
Not bad.
All right.
No, this is missing, though. Every good PowerPoint needs a chart.
Oh, you're right. You're right. We got to have something good to back up our data. Well, here I've got my target markets for Contoso. And I'm going to take these countries. Now, Excel's been about what? Formulas, numbers, text in a cell for a long time. And I'm going to use the power of Bing in the cloud to augment the smarts that Excel has about these entities. So if I look at the country of Colombia here, look what Excel now understands, the capital, a bunch of other stuff. What can I do with that? Well, I might be able to do things like put the population in there. Or maybe, for those of you that like object property syntax, I click on this cell and I simply type, oh gee, how about the area? Hit enter, and there I've got the area, right? Pretty straightforward. Now, Jeremy said I need a chart. Let's go take a couple of these fields here. I'll have Excel intelligently recommend a chart that might work for me. And of course, it understands these are geographic entities, drops the chart on there. Oops, France is kind of messing up my zoom here, so I'm going to temporarily, no offense to any French folks, I'm going to temporarily remove France from the filter and zoom in on the chart. So now that's I can great. Simply take that chart and I can copy it to the clipboard, drop it into my PowerPoint presentation.
Very cool. I know you got a few more things.
Well, there's another tab on my spreadsheet called Project Per... Ooh.
Oh, that doesn't look right.
Whoa. What? Let me...
Erica could not...
Yeah, I'll click a cell. I'll click a cell here. And let's just, oh, hey, wait a minute. ATP protected me. Advanced Threat Protection has been protecting me in email for some time.
Yep.
But now we're checking the reputation of hyperlinks across the Microsoft 365 applications.
Yes.
So now I can't hang myself, right?
And fun fact, because we don't require the control button to be pressed during the link click, this is the most attacked app, actually. So this is really good stuff.
Yeah, but I'm really kind of having a bad day. I'm a little concerned about this spreadsheet giving me a little trouble here.
Okay.
Do Do you have a copy?
Hold on. I got that thumb drive that I found on the bridge from the Hyatt to here. So why don't you try this
just
one?
Leaving it around? Okay, good. Because Jeremy finished his security training. We're just going to pop this thing in here. I mean, why not? What could go wrong? Let's see. The volume name is secret data. So I think you've definitely picked up something valuable here. And I'm just going to open up this market competitive analysis. Let's take a look at this spreadsheet. Okay, I'll load the data. Oh, I can't load the data because the macros. Oh, right. Well, let's just go turn on the macros. And Whoa.
That doesn't look good.
Well, let's click here to pay. I'll find some Bitcoin. Let's just go. Oh, can't do that either. Okay, so we are in a situation now where my files are getting encrypted.
Oh, you got some ransomware, it looks like.
Have you all seen Ferris Bueller's Day Off? Remember when they roll the tires backwards to try to make the, when he took dad's car?
But it didn't actually work in that movie, remember?
Well, it's going to work here because what we have now is AI coming alongside to say, hey, it looks like you may have been hit by some ransomware. You're not usually modifying this volume of documents on a daily basis. So, hey, how about we give you a little button here, go to OneDrive, and I can go now and restore my files back to a prior point in time. It'll be as if it never happened. So I simply select a date like yesterday. And here I can see the volume of changes and I can see the associated files underneath the covers. And when I select restore and go back to my files, there you can see they come synchronized back down from the cloud and I'm totally not impacted. And I didn't have to go buy Bitcoin in the middle of the night.
All right, so you got 5 minutes left. That was a long one, but a very good one. So let's keep going.
Okay, well, OneDrive does a whole lot more than protect you from malware. So I want to show you under the settings dialog here for OneDrive. If you go to auto save, we have something called known folder moves. These are all the sort of standard shell folders that are typically on the C drive. It'll simply intelligently redirect them to the cloud so that all of these benefits are extended to your files.
It's great for desktop deployment as well, because you can do this ahead of your re-imaging or redeployment.
And then you'll also notice here under screenshots, I can tell it to automatically save my screenshots to OneDrive. So any of you that are pulling together lots of different screenshots for training materials, you just go print screen, print screen, print screen, print. You got all of those now in your OneDrive and you can quickly pull them back. Very straightforward.
Very cool, very cool.
But now, another thing I want to draw your attention to is one of my favorites and it's called Files on Demand. So the good news is you can have lots and lots and lots of data on OneDrive. The bad news is your hard drive is not unlimited in capacity on a laptop, yes? On a portable device. And so when I type DIR on these files, I want you to kind of watch. On the right-hand side, I've got the green check mark. These are files that are temporarily on my hard drive because I use them. The ones with the cloud here are not synchronized, but I still have visibility to them. And if I scroll up here, I've got a solid green that is just telling me I've pinned it to the device so it doesn't ever actually go away. What's really fascinating about Files on Demand is the degree to which it's integrated in the shell. I want you to watch this file, OneDrive FOD. Notice over here, the files that are not synchronized still show up. You can see how big they are. They're just in parentheses because they're not synced down currently. So now I'm just going to issue a type command and tell it to type that file, but watch on the right-hand side when I hit enter, synchronizes down and OneDrive rocks. How about that?
Very good.
Access to all your files anytime, anywhere, on any device.
All right, so we're up to 11 demos. You got 3 minutes left. You got to beat last year's 12. So what do you got next?
Well, I want to tell you a little bit about something called Windows Timeline. Now, this little button down here traditionally brings up my multi-desktop view.
Right.
But if I scroll down a little bit further, Windows Timeline is actually keeping track of the apps and content that I'm accessing over a period of time. So now when I'm thinking about, I need to get back to what I was working on Friday, I don't lose context, I don't have to remember what the apps were, I don't have to remember where the data was. I just roll back in time, and this is synchronized across my Windows 10 experiences. So if I worked on it at the office, I can pick it right back up at home.
And with that, you've actually matched your demos from last year with 12, and hit Windows Tab as well to be able to get the timeline.
Fantastic. So what I'm gonna do now is I wanna show you one other thing that we got a lot of feedback on that we've improved for all of you in the room here today. What I'm going to do is bring up my colors setting. Now, this may seem like a small thing, but for those of you that work at night, you might really appreciate having the dark theme. More importantly, you might appreciate having the dark theme apply to classic Explorer windows as well. Sounds like there's a couple people in the room. Hey, I'm taking this stick
right,
out here.
I think you better take that out. Sketchy. I'll put that back in my pocket.
So we've got light theme, we've got dark theme. These are going to be great accessibility capabilities as well as to honor your preferences.
But I know there's even more on Windows 10, so why don't you show us some new stuff there as well?
I'd like to show you something sketchy at the moment.
All right.
And that's what
sketchier
we call
than this thumb drive,
screen
hopefully.
Sketch. Now this replaces the snipping tool. And I'm going to use my pen here to go ahead and grab myself a sketch on this screen like this. Maybe I wanted to reinforce the light and dark. And then you'll notice I accidentally kind of, the timing is killing me. It's the stress, Jeremy.
It's a lot of stress up here, isn't it?
So I'm going to drag this out. I'm going to accidentally kind of go too far there, and you'll see I can quickly and intelligently crop that. Very straightforward.
Very
but
cool.
Now I'm going to use my pen to mark it up. So I say, hey, I want to draw your attention to the dark theme here, but let's put a ruler up here, right? So now I can use the ruler just like you've used to seen in my other ink demos like that. But wait, protractors are not just for high school kids anymore. Let's put the protractor
right
down here, shall we? And we'll draw a circle around.
There we go.
Like that.
Nice.
Okay, and if you make a mistake, no big deal. We just turn the pen upside down, use the eraser, and go to town and erase that ink. How's that?
Very cool. So you got 1 minute left.
All right. 1 minute left. So the cloud clipboard. Now, copy paste is cool, but what I really like to do is collect and paste. How many of you want to copy more than one thing before you got to go? Yeah, exactly. So Windows V is the shortcut. And here you can actually see the things I've been copying in my clipboard, including prior images. There's that map from the Excel demo before. The clipboard synchronizes across your devices, so you have access to all of those wherever you are. So we hope you'll really enjoy that. I found a lot of great use cases for it myself.
All right, so you're up to 15 now. That's a few more than last year. You've got 30 seconds. Okay, let's see what else you can do on mobile.
All right, 30 seconds, fine. Last year, I think you might remember I did this. I forgot to expense this receipt. And so we put down a receipt, and we used something called Office Lens to capture it. Now Office Lens is built right into multiple applications, including the OneDrive app. So if I scan the receipt, you'll see it will outline the region of what the receipt is. I take the picture. It straightens the picture not so perfectly against the shiny surface.
All right.
Oh.
But you have to stop. So judges in the back, do we have some stoppage time? Stoppage time?
You're
How
killing
much?
Me.
1 minute? 2 minutes? We've got 2 minutes of stoppage time, but he's already beat his record from last year. So
All right.
Let's do 2 more minutes.
Let's wrap it. Here we go. Search for the image. CTAC, that's where I park my car. CTAC is nowhere in the name of the file. There's the receipt. Do you see CTAC about halfway down there? Tax, it's under tax, by the way. So there I can pull up my images and my content by where I was, what I was doing, and I don't. It's fantastic. Now, I'm gonna bring up PowerPoint. I showed you ideas earlier. Here's PowerPoint on my mobile device. I'm gonna drop a picture on this slide. And when I drop the picture on there, oh boy, there's some intelligence features coming about to help me, just like what I would expect. If I take slide 2, and then let's bring up the design surface and bring up design ideas, it's going to create a series of stunning designs for my slides, even while I'm mobile, right? Across every Microsoft 365 surface. 2 last things I want to show you, and then we'll wrap it up. We've got updates we've made to the SharePoint app as well. Here you can see it's very people-centric. You've got access to your recent files and featured links. Massive improvements in this application. I encourage you to check it out. And then finally, Microsoft Stream brings secure video to mobile, enables an offline experience, but more importantly, through AI, I can do things like search for culture, and there are the videos where the word culture is spoken. And I can see exactly in the stream where Patty is speaking about this. I can then watch the video, make it available offline, like it, add it to a watch list, and all of that related goodness. So that's
Very
a quick
cool.
overview of some of the great stuff we're doing in 365.
But you've got 38 seconds left. You forgot to tell us about all the greatness that is Office and the new UI updates.
Well, there are some improvements that have been made to Office, and earlier you may have caught it when I brought up my demo rollout. So here you can see we have something called the single line ribbon. This is about sort of maximizing your creativity space, if you will, and then delivering a consistent experience across the devices, from small device form factors to large device form factors. For those of you that love the full classic ribbon, of course, we continue to have that
All
as
right,
a choice.
All right, we're going to count you down. Seven,
did
six,
Did I win a Surface
five.
Go?
It's almost time to go. 3, 2, 1. All right.
20.
How'd we do?
I don't know if I should come back next year. That's a 20.
I know, you didn't sandbag at all. You got all the way through 20 demos. What do you think, guys? You like all this stuff? Any action?
Great.
All right,
Fantastic.
So before you go, you always asked, why don't you show us some new features and what's in Office? Where do I find all these capabilities that you've shown today?
I would assume if you're in this audience that you're a technology enthusiast and you kind of like being out in front of things. And so we have something called the Insiders Program, and that's the way you get access to early builds of Windows and Office. How many of you, by the way, are insiders already?
Anybody insiders?
Yeah, there you go. So
awesome.
Plenty of you are familiar with this, but I'd encourage you to jump in there, and that'll give you early exposure to all of the great innovation that we're showcasing today.
Very cool. So thanks for joining us again, Jack. And I'll see you next year, hopefully, for another Demopalooza where you can get more than 20.
Okay.
That's all the time we have for it. Follow us on Twitter and on YouTube. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Thank you.